Recording starts at 3 seconds. Welcome to Phantom Dust. So this is an old game, and it's such a weird and unique game that you're just gonna have to piss off with that. You're just gonna have to see. So, this game is free. I wanna make that clear right away. This game is free through the Windows Store, and if this looks interesting to you, you should absolutely go and play this game, because it is so weird and so amazing. Actually gonna turn some of the sound down, because it's a little loud. And it does not need to be that loud. So, I'm going to play through the story, but they do also have a multiplayer mode, which is super interesting. But, yeah, this is... You know what? Just watch.
Nobody remembers anything. Not when the world changed. Nor why. A mysterious dust poisoned the surface, affecting the brains of humans and stealing their memories. Strange apparitions began to appear. Humans fled their devastated cities. Only underground could humans escape the demons and the dust. It gave something new. The ability to transform their will into energy. This is a new breed. The Espers risk their lives searching the surface world for clues. On the surface that might let us recover the memories we've lost.
excited. I love this game.
It's here. What I'm searching for. Something important. Something you're in place for. Something I lost. I must go.
Go.
Everything about this game except for the protagonist's design. I like Edgar's design way more. I'm gonna let this first episode run a little bit long because we're 5 minutes in and all we've done is cutscenes. Chapter 1, Man with Amnesia. That's a different game. We're not playing that one. Ah, I'll fix that later. Hello, Edgar.
Who are you? That face. I know you. I think. Wait a minute. Who am I? And what is this place? Hey, tell me! What? You've lost your memory, too?
You've lost your memory, too? Weird space to put a comma.
Shoot, what the hell is going on?
I don't know. I'm gonna leave now. Good luck. Never mind. I guess I don't leave now. Talk to me some more. Hey, is that door open? No, it isn't, actually.
Finally woken up, I see.
Were you the one that brought us here? Why don't you tell us what happened?
You've no memory at all, is that right? Just an image of some ancient ruins. And a strange gut feeling that you have to go there.
But how did you know that?
Everybody's the same, all of us. Now you. Please, follow me. I'll explain everything once we arrive.
Yeah, let's go with the weird little creature.
It happened just like I told you. None of us remembers anything. We live in this world we don't understand, with people without memories wandering around, with monsters roaming the surface and these strange particles and paranormal skills.
I see. This place is like the lost and found counter at a catastrophe discount store. So, we're lost sheep with no memory. Just like you.
There is one difference. The two of you were found in strange metal pods. But Leader says we are all lost souls. All we have left is this underground world. And our scraps of memories and the image of the ruins in our heads.
The ruins. The image I saw in my dream.
Leader says that the fact we all share the same image must be more than mere coincidence. He's right, I think. And so we are systematically searching the surface world for the ruins. We hope you can help with that search as well.
Are you saying you want us to join the Visions?
We are very short-handed, especially when it comes to people with skills.
But I am haunted by the ruins. I'll give it some thought.
Such a generous man is our leader. Leader says, Edgar, take your time. You don't mind us calling you Edgar, do you? We saw your locket, too. You care about the woman in the photograph, don't you? Perhaps helping us will lead you to find her. And you. We should find a name for you as well. You need a name even if you don't have memories. Just pick a name that sounds good to you, and we'll call you that. Everyone picks their names here. Or perhaps you're one of the lucky ones who remembers his real name?
He never speaks. He just grunts awkwardly. Seems that you don't recall your name. Here are some options. Based on the location we found you, based on the location where you two were found, we'll call you Alpha. It means where all things begin. It also means the unknown. No. I see. Okay. Ice is perfect for you. The capsule in which you two were found was frozen. Yes. I know. From now on, I'll call you Ice. That's your name. First things first, go meet Meister, the combat instructor. He's waiting for you two at the battle terminal. Yeah. Let's do this. Let's do battle. I fucking love this game. Okay, I have to change one thing. Is it in help and support? Nope, I feel like that's gonna fuck everything up in a second. Alright, no options, I guess. Hello, No. You're new here, aren't you? I missed what you said. My name? If I tell you, by the time you reach the surface, you'll have forgotten it. Okay. So I believe it's down here. Subutaki. Ah, it did fuck everything up. One second. Okay, we're good. Like I said, we're gonna let the first episode run a little bit long, because so far we've just been in cutscenes, and I want to actually show off what this game is. It's not beer. Where is the friggin' combat place? It's been so long since I last played this game, like probably 15 years. So my memory is gonna be a bit, it's gonna be a bit off for a little while. Clinic, no. So perhaps it was not down here. I can't go up the stairs where No is, because he will not let me through. Hello, I. Nice coat. Why couldn't I have a coat that was feathers instead of belts? Battle terminal. Here we go. And it's down this way to talk to this guy. How the fuck did you get over here? Ahead is a place that's not for you, rookie. Well, fuck you then. I guess it's over here. Meister. Oh, it's you. What they say is true. You have the look. I am Meister, the Vision's combat instructor. I'll accompany you on the surface until I'm confident you can fend for yourself. Okay. It's never a bad idea to have a meat shield. This is the battle terminal. The exit behind you leads to the surface. Here, you receive your missions. That man there, Tetsuya, go talk to him. Okay. He'll assign you a mission. Okay. Taking a mission, let me explain how missions work. The visions do not allow underground dwellers to visit the surface. We scouts take care of all surface tasks. We call these missions. Let's see, right now... there's a mission here from Meister. How convenient. Uggtown. Let's go to the surface. You've got what it takes. The next few lectures detail attack and defense skills. After this, you will understand the basics of combat. Win Meister's approval. I'll never be able to win his approval. You and Edgar were found in an emergency capsule. Edgar yearns to find the woman whose picture is in his locket. All right. How do you like being on the surface again? Take a look around.
Use the right thumbstick to move the camera. Click the right thumbstick to center the camera again.
Thank you, GLaDOS. Beautiful sky, isn't it? It's what I miss most, living underground. That's why we need to find the ruins, so we can go back to the surface for good. First things first, how's your health right now?
The flashing bar in the upper left corner is your health meter. When your health reaches zero, you fail the mission.
Also, you die.
The flashing number in the lower right corner is your energy level, called aura. Each skill requires a certain amount of aura to use. The number below your aura number is your level, which reflects the number of aura particles you've picked up. You lose some aura when you use a skill, but it regenerates up to this level over time. Some attacks are best avoided by moving out of the way. Click the left thumbstick to jump.
Sorry, GLaDOS. Here's how to use skills. What's that noise? An enemy?
To locate the enemy, pull the right trigger. This will lock you onto the target.
Oh, there it is. This one over there. Dun, dun, dun!
You have successfully locked onto the enemy, the Omato.
I guess I'll just stay quiet for this first episode.
You cannot move the camera while you are locked onto an enemy. To deactivate your target lock, pull the right trigger again.
I know it's your first time out, but I want you to join me. See that red capsule floating on the stairs? It's a cluster of energized dust particles. That contains an attack skill. Go over there and get it. Okay. I'll draw the Omato to me. The Tomato. Grab that skill and get to work. Okay.
Use the left thumbstick to move to the skill capsule.
Okay.
Stand next to a capsule to view a panel with information about the skill. When the information panel appears, press any button, A, B, X, or Y, to assign the skill to that button. Attack the Yamato with the Bullet of Fire. You need 2 aura each time you use it. Bullet of Fire is a medium-range attack. It's most accurate when the targeting reticle is yellow.
That I did not know, or did not remember. Because some of these actually have a weird attack range. Ow, kick. Yeah, there's gonna be a lot of that.
You don't have enough aura to use this skill. Your aura will regenerate over time.
I did it. Not bad. Few defeat the enemy their first time out, just as I suspected. Unnatural. Dude, I've done this before. I've attained a memory box. O3 is responsible for the machines, mostly because he seems to remember a few things about computers. Alright, that's gonna do it for this first episode. I hope you guys are excited to go on this adventure with me, because legitimately, I love this game. It's so strange and so unique, and there's never been anything really like it that I've seen, anyway. Maybe you guys know something I don't. Maybe you know a game that's like similar to this, or like a spiritual successor or something like that, and if you do, I would love to hear it. I would love to try more games like this one. But until then, I will see you guys for the next episode. Take care.